So that's more or less a piece of history. And then let me finish in the next, say, 10 minutes or so with a summary of what we call the strategic plan. And you have copies of a summary of it. We have a much bigger document, only local, but we gave you a summary so that you can follow it up. And I warn you, this is only a vision, because of course everything is subject to eventually receiving the corresponding funding. But I think it's better to come up with a vision before any funding application. So let me just start with education. Education. One of the projects we have is to initiate a PhD program at ICTP, directly at ICTP. This is important for us for several reasons. First, we have this diploma program, which is very, very, very successful. After that year, the students are at the top level to compete with the students from the United States or Europe to go to top institutions in the world. And we send them there. So many of them have been successful. On the other hand, sometimes we lose track of them because they leave ICTP. It was only 1 year with us, and then they can go to the other institutions, and sometimes we lose the connection with them, and we would like to have them closer to us so that they can also help us to promote science in their own countries. And ideally, it would be ideal that they go back to their own countries. And having a PhD program in-house, we have always a direct connection with our own countries, will help us in that. And that was a natural complement to the diploma program we have. So I think this is very important for the student. For us, it's a way to help us to increase our and improve our research. Because this, coming myself from a university environment, I know very well that the people who make the core of a research group are the students. So having graduate students in-house is crucial to keep our researchers active and to make the place much more active in research. And we have been in conversations with the United Nations University. The director is here, if not, or he's coming. And also with CISA and other institutions to see if we can actually start a PhD program originally in our four main research sections. We are also discussing new diploma programs. So in the same way we have a diploma in basic physics, we would like to have something in basic mathematics. Also, there are proposals for high performance computing, medical physics, that has been a school very successful. It can be promoted to a diploma with a visitor scientist coming here to lecture rather than the local scientists, et cetera. We can expand this sandwich program that I mentioned before to include other institutions in the developed world, because we know it's very successful. We have limitations of how many supervisors we can provide, and we can expand it to other institutions. This sandwich PhD can be very much more enhanced. And teacher training, we would like, so we are concentrated mostly on high-level education. Well, we think it's very important to promote the science at the lower level. We cannot do all of it, but at least to help train the teachers with institutions such as UNESCO, CERN, Ames, the Millennium Project in Cambridge, and so on, we can do it. I know CERN is working also with UNESCO in this effect, and I think we are planning to work and collaborate with them in these initiatives. For research, as we mentioned before, the crucial thing for us is to keep the highest possible level of research, so we want to reinforce our current groups. We are starting 5-year postdoc, prestigious postdocs, so that to have the gap between the young postdocs and our staff, and have a few but very active senior postdocs that can run and be the link between the young students, postdocs, and the faculty. This I know is very works very well in many institutions, and I think is going to start here and make a difference. We also would like to have to actually revamp our staff associateships. We have some top scientists in the world that we want to attract and be here for a month or two per year, so that to improve and make much more stronger our research programs. And we're trying to make an effort to fill this gender gap in the scientific staff. For research, the plans, the hope is to eventually, if we want to expand, we can think in which area can we expand? Which are the things that we think we can do our best in our mission? And we came out with at least three. probably listed here probably in the priorities. One, as it was mentioned before, energy and sustainability is something that is very important. We consider it's very important for the whole world, but also for the developing world, which is our main mission. And it fits so well with the climate change group that we have here, so it's a natural expansion. So we think that having a group on energy and sustainability complements very well our activities in climate change. And we are in discussion with neighbor institutions like CISA to work together and try to establish as a program on energy and sustainability. On computational biology, this is something that I find very exciting, and it's something that is relatively recent, something I couldn't have thought at the time of Salam or before, because it's the new developments in biology have brought biology to a level where computational aspects are very important. And for computational aspects, our expertise as physicists and mathematicians is precisely what is needed to approach many of the new problems in biology, because we are booming out of data by the sequencing of many, say, species. And there's a lot of data that has to be analyzed in a quantitative way, and physicists and mathematicians are very well trained for that. And it's a nice way to enter into this. And it's very important for the developing world, because this is much related with health. And so something that we would like to promote very much. The same in computing sciences. We have ideas on how to expand in this, to create, if possible, eventually activities here. At the moment, all this will be at the level to start one of the programs, all these 60 programs we have per year. We can start with these activities and then study in which way we can actually make it into more permanent activity in the ICTB. Okay. For outreach, we would like to aim at establishing branches of ICTP in different countries. We're in collaboration, as we said before in my presentation, has been mentioned also before. Now, with the big changes in the world, we want to collaborate with emerging countries like China, India, Brazil, and Mexico, and so on, to Argentina, and so on, to try to establish branches of ICTP in different regions. As I mentioned before, we are trying to start now with one in Brazil, and we have one in plan in Cameroon, and many of the others could be discussed in different regions of the world. And this, I think, is very important since we know that we have been exploring all these activities for all these 45 years. We know what works and we know what doesn't work. And in that sense, the model of ICTP can be easily adapted to different regions, and we know that we can provide our expertise and know-how to help establishing these centers. We would also like to collaborate with other developed world countries where they can actually have activities in there where probably not at the level of ICTP, but in their own way to do it. And the possibility will be to have United States being involved in the activities of ICTP, something that Salam tried in the 1980s, and it was attempted, and it will be something that it will be good to have other developed countries to get involved and work with us in our mission. something that is, I'm very sensitive to it, especially because of my origin from Central America, most of the concentration of ICTP has been at the postgraduate level, whereas some of the activities that we offer, countries like mine cannot apply because we don't have a PhD program, for instance. And many countries are like that. So I think we need to help establish programs aimed at undergraduate students. And for that collaboration with emerging economies, that will be probably the most efficient way to go. Continuing with our outreach, we'd like to establish in place what we call experimental techniques for training and development, which just to have our different experimental activities to concentrate in one single unit that will be mostly developed for training and development. And that's something we're studying that possibility. Just not to compete doing research, but just to have a minimum set of experimental equipment that we can use to mostly for training. The concept of TRIL has been so successful that there's no reason why not to extend it to other countries. So in all the whole Europe, for instance. The activities of ICTP online are one of, I would say, my priorities. And now things have been moving. We have last week a very interesting conference that I urge you to look at it. And there's a very book out of it. It's called N-Science. It's a mobile science, something that's to use the mobile equipment, mobile phones, for instance, as a scientific instrument. And this is very important, I would say, for the developing world. Something I learned recently is that 73% of the mobile phones are in the developing world. So 73%. So it's most of the mobile phones are there. So we have activities where you can use mobile phones that can have reach, that can reach so many people. And that's I'm very impressed that with this activity last week. And not only that there was the activity, but there's also already a book that is free to download if you want to see what all the things that have been developed there. We're trying to do something we call physics.tv. We got the domain. And one of the things to do there is to try to disseminate and create a library of scientific information online, hopefully with the help of MIT, the Perimeter Institute, KITP, et cetera. One thing we want to have is create a systematic database of ICTP visitors and associates, and also to create a pool of lecturers that can help us in our many activities. So for all that, it's good to dream, which I think is good to have a vision and try to achieve something. And of course, we will not be able to achieve all of that in 5 years, but at least we try to aim at that. And but to try to achieve those things, we would like to have what is called in other many places the Institutional Advancement Office. So it's an office that could help us to look for collaborations and further funding. So collaborations with other scientific institutions to enhance our mutual impact. So we can have budget constraints all institutions can have, but if we work together, we can make a bigger impact. And there are many institutions that are listed here for which we can work together, and we have already worked together to enhance our impact. The thing I mentioned is collaboration with emerging countries, institutions, and governments, and that we can, again, use our expertise, our models, to work with the emerging countries and for them to help us to help the other countries, and I'm sure they can help us organize many activities. In particular, I mentioned there are these initiatives from the Brazilian Physical Societies and the Mexican Physical Societies that will be announced in this conference. One thing we would like to have is to establish an endowment for ICTP projects. For instance, OEA projects, the Office of External Activities projects, we may have an endowment that for which we can use to help many of the activities that are done abroad, and that will be an efficient way to enhance our impact. And of course, we want to have a proactive way to approach funding agencies for concrete projects and institutional support. In particular, for instance, I'm happy to announce that we just have an agreement with the Ely Foundation, the local Ely Foundation. You know the famous coffee, Ely's coffee. The president of the foundation is here, Roberto. And we are just signing an agreement to start a project on environmental change and coffee. So that is an example of activities that we can do together with private funding. Okay, thank you very much.